This is cool. It's a must book it. So I got the thing that I wanted, which is this. Yeah. Yes, oh, thank goodness. Okay, yes, transparent watercolor crayon. So I'm going to test this out today, and then hopefully I can use it tomorrow. Alright, and then I got some acrylic gel. It says it dries clear, which is what I want, and I wanted matte. Is this matte? Maybe not. Well, I guess we're gonna find out if that's matte or glossy. And I got these two pens. And then I got a crap load of paper. I know that I've already gotten a crap load of paper, but my idea for my next sketchbook, even though I'm nowhere near having a new sketchbook, is to have a complete mix of random stuff. So it's this lovely cream color, and I got gray Canson. So yeah, I wanted to have a bunch of different textures and things because, you know, sometimes I don't want to do sketches on my thick papers, but I don't want to do watercolor on sketch papers, so I kind of want to have a mix. I got this plum one. It was just laying around, so I grabbed it. What's this? Oh, this is the Stonehenge Fawn. I used to do all of my journals in Stonehenge before they became $5 a sheet. It used to be $2.50, I think. So that's a huge price jump, which is why I haven't been using it. But I wanted to get one for future journal and one to paint on, because I really like the way watercolors work on this color. And this was some drawing paper, because I wanted to have a few light things in there too. I got three sheets. They're fairly large. I have no idea what they are. And I got vellum. Acrylic or thick wash on that, maybe. Some kind of cool marker stuff. I don't know. And this big one is Yupo. You're supposed to be able to use watercolor on this, too. This one's pretty big, so I might cut off a piece just to play with before binding it into some kind of journal. So yeah, so now I know what I'm going to do this afternoon. So in order to get everything to be the same size in the end, I had to trim everything down to either 22 by 30 or half of that. So I have a bunch of scraps, which will be fun. I can make more half journals or mini journals or whatever. The Yupo was super hard to fold in. I couldn't rip it, so I had to cut it with scissors, which is not super ideal. But that means that any artwork you do on this stuff will not rip by accident. So that's interesting. The medium turned out to be glossy. Let's test out the ground. It hasn't been 24 hours, but where's my paint? My desk is a mess. Okay. There's glitter in my paint box. Why? I made my own glitter watercolor paint. That's cool. Alright. I did just smear it on, so it may not be enough. So here's what I ended up with for art journals, extra ones. They're not as... They're going to be much thinner than the ones that I normally make. But I can't really do much about that because I'm already sort of at my maximum cost. Because these papers are more expensive. So I'll show you. So two of these are going to have the plum and the gray. Because I only had three pieces of it. But the other one's just going to have extra pieces of the fawn and the Somerset. So it's about the same. In fact, the Somerset and the fawn are nicer and cost more than the other ones. So you kind of get a good deal with that. Anyway, so I have the heavy drawing paper, which is not super different from the paper that I'm using now, I don't think. I guess it's kind of lighter, but not by much. And I have vellum, which is why it's thinner, because it's physically thinner. I'm just excited about having a sketchbook with vellum in it, because when you paint with acrylics on vellum, it looks really cool. And yeah, here's some more vellum. Place is kind of a disaster. Yeah. So here's the fawn, I think, the Stonehenge. And then I guess this last signature has the Yupo in it. Yes, I decided to put a piece of Yupo in each of these for people who want to try it out. I haven't actually tried it yet, so I'm sure that will happen in this vlog sometime. It's kind of really thick. It's not as white as it looks in other YouTube videos, for example. I've been sort of looking into it. I'm not super sure what I'm going to be able to do with that, but let's see. This is the Somerset, I think. And so this would be one art journal. It should have as many pages as mine usually do, except I added an extra piece of vellum. So yeah, I'm excited about those. I don't know when I'm going to make these up. I kind of want to have more art to put on the front, which means I actually have to start painting things. I have to stop testing stuff and building stuff and actually paint stuff, because it's been a while. And I'm excited. Look at these. Mine's up there. I haven't pulled it yet. I really want to try some stuff on Yupo. I know it's 2 o'clock and I should probably live stream or something, but like, it's Yupo! Okay. So one thing I've noticed is that pencil is so nice. Like, it's so smooth and dark. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I don't know what watercolor is going to do on this. Probably nothing good. Let's see. I'll just sit right in this mess here. Oh, cool. Okay. That's actually not bad. I thought it was going to resist more. Ooh, it's bending. Let's try my one Prismacolor marker here. Eh, can't do things one-handed. Okay, cool, I guess. Meh. Holy cow, it's reacting horribly. It's like curling up like a little leaf. So it does calm a little bit when it dries. Good. Jesus. That was crazy. That's cool. Okay, I'm gonna try out the frisket here. It's all kind of shiny. I almost wonder if I shouldn't have used the gel medium, because it kind of looks cool like this too. Whoa. neat. Neat. Well, it works really good on absorbent papers. Not so much on this. Then nothing really does. It's cool though. Maybe it's too much. Okay, so I'm doing my first real like experiment with Yupo and it's freaking amazing. I love it. I love the way like the colors just pool together and you can't control anything and it's okay because it's watercolor. That's what watercolor's for. So I'm using like the pencil is very smooth. I used pencil crayon. It was okay. This red is a Sharpie paint pen. I sprayed the background on. Where I rubbed it off, it stained a little bit. But it still looks really cool. Like the fact that you could just rub whatever you don't want off. And it feels like a print because it's plastic. And you can see through it. Sort of. It looks so cool. So yeah, I'm super happy that I bought that. And it will be really awesome in the sketchbooks, absolutely. Suddenly the sunshine, Mo, what happened? What is this? You remember this? Sunshine, Mo. You're all warm. Tree just barely made it.